Hi, 你们好 ，Welcome back with Ivy's Chinese lesson. Today, I will teach you the daily basic conversation, which are, what's your name? Second, where are you from? Third, may I help you? Fourth, can you help me? Okay, let's begin. The first one is, what's your name? In Chinese is, 你叫什么名字？你叫什么名字？Okay, here is, there's a grammar. In Chinese, for the question sentences, it's not like English. You put this question word at the beginning of the sentence, like, how are you, what do you do, what are you working, and what's your name? And all of this English, they put this question word at the beginning of the sentence, and then put the question mark, but Chinese is different. Chinese, almost all the question sentences is the same like the sentence structure. The sentence structure is the same like this declarative sentence. So we just put a question mark at the end. Like for there are two situations also. The first situation is within this sentence, there is a question word. It's like what, 什么,什么。So we know this is a Chinese question sentence. 你叫什么名字? If we just translate it to like from one word and one word by one word to English, it will be you called what name? You called what name? 你 you 叫 call 名字 name 名字 name but if we translate from this English sentences, what's your name? It will be 什么是你的名字？什么是你的名字？ We can understand, but in Chinese, we use this way. We normally use this way. 你叫什么名字？你叫什么名字? What's your name? What's your name? And the second one is, where are you from? Where are you from? 你来自哪里? Same, 哪里 is where. And come from, where are you from? Come from, come, 来, from, 字, come from, 来自, 哪里。Where are you from? 你来自哪里？你来自哪里？ Same the sentence structure, same like this declarative sentence. No need to change the order. Still subject, verb, and object. Okay, but we change a little bit of the tone, because when we're hearing, you're asking something, the tone, it will be little like rising. Like, and the light, the last word is rising, the tone is rising, and the light. 你来自哪里?你来自哪里?你叫什么名字?你叫什么名字?你叫什么名字? Okay, the third one is, this one I think is very useful for for who is working this service company. They want to attract or grasp this Chinese customer. So you can say, 你需要帮忙吗? You need help? 你需要帮忙吗? 你, you, 需要, need, or want, 帮忙, 帮忙, help, help, 帮忙帮忙, this one we can use as a verb and also can be used as a noun. 你需要帮忙吗? For this sentence, if it's a declarative sentence, it's 你需要帮忙, 你需要帮忙. So this is like a firmly declarative sentence, but we need to make a question one, so we just add 吗, 吗 at the end of the sentence, so it will constitute these question sentences. Just add ma, because during this sentence we don't have this question word like what, how, and where. We don't have this 什么, 怎么 and 哪里 So we just add 妈 at the end of this sentence. 你需要帮忙吗 You need help? And then you can answer, Yes, I need help. 是我需要。是我需要帮忙。Oh, no need help. No, no need, no need. 不需要。Thank you. 不需要。不需要，谢谢。不需要，谢谢。No need help. Thank you. 不需要，谢谢。And another one is very useful sentences. It's if you go to China, and if you're not lucky, if you're not lucky, you will find all the Chinese don't speak English in China. And then you're seeking for help.And then say, oh my god, nobody speaks English, what can I do? So this sentence will help you. 你可以帮我吗? Can you help me? 你可以帮我吗? 你, you, 可以, can, 帮我, 帮, 帮, help. This 帮 is a verb. 帮我吗?你可以帮我吗？你可以帮帮我吗？你可以帮我吗 ？Same this one, the sentence structure is the same like this declarative sentence. Just add 妈 at the end of the sentence, so we make it a question sentence. 你可以帮我吗？你可以帮我吗 ？The tone, the last word will be light and rising. 你可以帮我吗？And then if you only know what I taught you, if you only know the Chinese sentence I taught you by now, after this, then you can start your body language. Maybe you're looking for a restaurant, then you can like this, like this. If you want to go to the airport, maybe like this. Okay, just use your imagination, okay? 你可以帮我吗？I said, yes, 可以可以可以 If they are very, all the Chinese people, they are very kind, they will say, 可以可以 And maybe you, then you start to show them the map. Oh, here, here, I want to go here, there. Okay. If no, no. Maybe they just shake their head like this. It means no. Second meaning is don't understand. If your pronunciation is not correct, so just pronounce it correct. 你可以帮我吗? Okay, so today we learned four question sentences, the basic one, the very useful one. The first one is 你叫什么名字?你叫什么名字? And you can answer 我叫My name is 叉叉叉叉叉。我叫你叫什么名字？我叫 add your name。你叫什么名字？我叫 Ivy。Okay, where 你来自哪里 ？Where are you from？ 你来自哪里？我来自中国。我来自美国。我来自英国。我来自阿联酋 ，UAE。我来自阿联酋。Okay, third one is you need help or may I help you? 你需要帮忙吗？你需要帮忙吗？你需要帮忙吗？你需要帮忙吗？是需要，我需要，我需要，不需要，谢谢，不需要，谢谢。The last one is 你可以帮我吗？你可以帮我吗？你可以帮我吗? Okay, I hope you like this lesson. Thanks for watching. If you have any comments or any doubts, just write down our reply as soon as possible. And thank you. See you next lesson. 再见。拜拜。爱你们，么么哒。